Hi guys, so we're here officially at Kennedy Space Center, and right now we are walking through the entrance, and I'm about to show you this beautiful fountain with a picture of President Kennedy. And the NASA.
Hey, come on. We'll go through it on the way up because you keep looking.
Okay, look at this beautiful sculpted mural. And it is the Heroes and Legends of the United States Astronaut Hall of Fame. Our next stop is going to be in the Rocket Garden, and we'll see you soon.
At the edge, okay?
There's a, look, there. So what they did, the astronauts would put their head right here and then they'll put their legs right there.
Oh, so cool. So this is a little capsule.
Yeah.
Come on. This is awesome. You were in an actual
capsule. Here we are inside the Heroes Hall. The Mercury Atlas.
Believe in myself started with a very small act from a man named Gene Cernan. For many years, he sent me patches from each of the Apollo space missions.
Guys like John Glenn and Gus Wilson and John Glenn.
Alan Shepard, Wallace Shaw, John Glenn.
In my opinion, he came as an American hero, but he never acted like such.
So this is actually what I really admire the most. People that were out on the forefront of exploration, primitive, the lives of the line.
Those guys are the real heroes.
I was very impressed with their accomplishments.
I can't imagine ever doing what they do. It's amazing.
They're all the same type of personalities. You know, they work hard, they set goals, they achieve.
We always have a skill of being so.
Walk up to the airplane, you always kick the tires just to be sure they're not flat. This particular rocket I was never going to see again. So I just stopped as I approached it, looked up into the glare of the spotlights, and then took a look at the rocket.
Thank you.
This is Mercury Mission Control. Can you imagine that this is how they sent the men to space in 1962 on those old computers? We've definitely come a long way.
One, blast off. These are the old.
This is going to be beautiful, guys. Here from the beginning of our tour and seeing the rocket garden and how our spacecrafts have evolved. So some from rockets that could never be used in space again to a shuttle that could be used repetitively over again. All stemmed from one idea. So this is the cockpit of the spaceship shuttle Atlantis. And generally they would have this open, but because of COVID and everything, they actually have it closed. Closed for your health and safety, but let's see. Get you an inside look there. And on the other side, so it's the same thing. You see the glass panels. And I'll try to get it from the inside for you. Just a little bit of a different view. Are from all the travel of Space Shuttle Atlantis. This is just one side of the wall closed. Space program that you have. And so this is a dedication to the astronauts that we've lost in these missions. We have Challenger here. These are all personal items that once belonged to these men and women. Wow, look at that. Cub Scouts, Star Trek. And that's why we say these fallen friends and heroes are definitely heroes, men and women. Our day at Kennedy Space Center has concluded, and we hope you enjoyed our time with us and enjoyed the day. Right, guys?
Yep, very fun.
Yeah.
Lots of rockets.
Peace out.